Hello and welcome to a Unraid Quickie video on the different ways to connect your Unraid shares to your Windows machine. As a prerequisite, we of course need a running Unraid server. With its IP, we can then connect to the web interface, where we then go over to the main tab. Here we have to make sure that the parity and disk drives have been set, and then have our array started. Once the array is started, we can head over to the Shares tab. Here we go on to Add Share, where we will add the share that we want to connect to our Windows machine. In this case, I will use the YouTube test share. Next, we will go to the Users tab. Here we will select Add User, and then add the user who we want to have accessing the newly created share. In my case, test user with the password test user. Once the user is created, we can head back to shares and select our newly created share. When we scroll down to the SMB security settings, we will be able to select how we want to export our share. We select no, the share will not be exported at all, and we cannot access it from our Windows machine. If we select yes, we will be able to access the share and also visually see that the share exists. If we select yes but hidden, we will be able to connect to the share, but we will not be able to see that the share exists. For demonstration purposes, I will be selecting yes hidden. In the security tab, we can select between public, secure, and private. Public means that any user can connect to the share and read and write. Secure means that anyone can read, but only a select few users can actually write onto the share. Private means that we can select manually which user has which type of permission onto the share. In my case, I'll be using private and then click apply. Once I have applied it, I will get a list of all the users currently configured in the Unraid. In our case, this is just the test user. Currently, the test user has no access to the newly created share. We can select him to have no access, read only, or read and write. For this purpose, I'll be selecting read only, and then apply. And this concludes the configuration in the web UI, and now we can go to the Windows Explorer. Because we have created a share that can only be accessed by a very specific user, I usually like to go to the Windows Credential Manager first, then over to Windows Credentials, add a Windows credential, and here I can add the IP address or name of my server, in this case YouTube Tutorial, the standard name would be Tower, then add the user that is able to access the share that I want to access, and his password. With this set, Windows will always use the username and password we have defined here when accessing any shares on the server YouTube tutorial. This will save us the hassle of always having to enter a username and password when trying to access the share. There are three ways to access your share. The first one is via the Network tab. Here, you'll be able to see all the computers currently visible in the network. If you have a standard Unraid installation, your server will be called Tower. In my case, I have renamed the server to YouTube Tutorial. After I double-click onto it, I will then be able to see all the shares I have exported and not hidden. Because we have set our newly created share to hidden, it does not appear in this list. I can, however, still manually add this share by just typing in its name up here, YouTube Test Share. And there, I can access it. Because I only have read-only permissions, I am not able to actually create anything on this share. If I actually want to see this share visible here, I will have to set the export settings to yes. Once this is done, the YouTube test share will appear directly. The second way to access the share is via the network location. Here I can click Next, then choose a custom network location, and then put in the location of the share. I can either do it via Browse, where then, after a few seconds, all the available computers in the network should appear. Like here, then you can go to your server and see all the publicly available shares. In this case, YouTube test share, then we can press OK. You can also just type this in manually. It's 2 backslashes, then the IP or name of your server, then another backslash and the name of your share. Then we press next. We can give it a name. We can click finish. And now we actually have a share that we can access via this network location. If you double click onto it, we're into the share and we still have the same permissions, so we cannot actually create a folder in this share. The third way is by adding a network drive. Here we can select a drive letter, and then it's the same thing again. We can either go via browse or we can manually add the address where the share is located. In this case, YouTube tutorial, and then YouTube test share. Here we can also say reconnect at sign-in. That means that after we reboot our Windows machine, we will still be able to see the network drive, and we can connect using different credentials. This is something that we would have to do if we did not add the username and password to the Windows credential manager in the first place. Let's click finish here, and we'll try to connect to the share. And once it succeeds, we now have this network drive located here, and we can access it at any time and can also use it as a normal Windows drive by using its letter. And that already concludes the Unraid Quickie video on how to connect your Unraid shares to your Windows machine. If you have any further questions, just leave them below and I'll try to answer them as fast as possible.